아, 이제 한번 나마스테.
네.
하나, 둘, 셋.
나마스테.
나마스테. 안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
So, I met Sunar today. Actually, I wanted to ask something about India. So, I messaged her, can I meet you and can I interview? So, that's why I met her today. So, can you introduce yourself first?
Hello. Hi. Namaste. My name is Sunar Yadav and I'm an Indian YouTuber. And I make vlogs here and also videos about beauty and everything because I love beauty and we have like beauty heaven here in Korea. So if you want to check out my channel name is Sonal Yadav. And I'm learning Korean language from Seoul National University. And this is my third semester and everything is going good. Yeah.
I get it. And why are you learning Korean language?
Oh, my main reason is why I'm learning Korean because I'm really into K-pop, K-drama and Korean culture, festivals and Indian in like some ways they are like similar. So I wanted to live here for some time to see like Korean life, their local life, how Korean people actually live and their traditions, culture, festival and everything. So that's why I chose Korea and learn Korean language so I can like pick up really fast. Yeah, that's why.
Is it hard to learn Korean language?
No, it's not hard to learn Korean language. It's fun, and if you have interest to learn any language, you will pick up fast and you will learn easily if you have interest. Yeah.
And she can speak Korean really well.
아니요.
I heard.
아니요. 버려.
버려. Is there really a lot of places and language in India? And can I ask you where do you belong to?
Oh, basically I'm from Agra. Yeah, Agra.
Agra?
Where Taj Mahal is. Seven Wonders.
Seven Wonders?
Yeah.
Oh, ah, Taj Mahal. You live here?
No, I don't live here. This is my hometown. Mm-hmm. And then I moved to, when I was like 17, 18, I moved to New Delhi. And in India, we have like 22 major languages. Mm-hmm. And with that, we have official language Hindi. And I speak Hindi. And also, we have one foreign language English, which is English and which is like commonly used in India. And yeah, so and we also have other mainly 1,000 other regional languages. So we have so many languages. Okay. Yeah, so you can imagine how diverse is India.
So they can speak English but they have their own language too.
Yeah. But common language is English because in India not so many people, not everyone can speak Hindi too. Only like middle India. Yeah, that's it. So yeah.
Have you ever been to Indian restaurant in Korea? And is it really like weird Indian food?
Oh yeah, I have been to like many Indian restaurant because I miss Indian food so much
in
Korea.
I've been many times.
Oh really? Wow. So I visited so many Indian restaurants but their taste is like so all what they do is they make like one base with every curry. They mix with every like chicken curry and they use for every curry. And mainly people working in those restaurants are mainly Nepal. So they call Indian restaurant, but they are Nepalese. But recently I found out about one restaurant, Indian restaurant, near my university, Seoul Daehakgyo.
We are Indian.
Yeah, authentic Indian. It's called Otsal. And their food is a little bit expensive, but food is super delicious and like real authentic Indian. So if you ever visit to like Korea, then you should definitely go to Otsal restaurant. They have like really wide variety. They also have vegetarian menu.
Can I go together?
Why not? Yeah, why not?
In Han? Where?
Otsal, Seoul Daehakgyo Gunjeo.
Seoul Daehakgyo Gunjeo? Okay, 가자.
네.
I'm so interesting.
Yeah.
Next question. This is my 개인적인, individual question.
네.
Bollywood movies are really good and famous in Korea, like Three Idiots, Slumdog Millionaire, Dangal, or Dangal is listen. And my name is Khan. This is my favorite movie, really.
You know, Slumdog Millionaire is not Bollywood movie. It's Hollywood movie.
Ah, really?
Yeah, but
Indian actor.
Yeah, it based on Bollywood.
Based on Bollywood.
Yeah.
So, it's really famous and good. So how do you think about that and why do you think Indians make the good movies.
You know, before, like, really old time, back then, we made, like, movies. We focused on movies like drama, fantasies, romance and everything. But nowadays, we are focusing on, like, real issues. And also based on true story and topics like so many people can relate, and also topics like education, women. If you take an example, that Three Idiots,
education,
Dangal, women, for women empowerment and everything, and also which movie?
My name is Khan
is for like Muslim,
like religion and the human rights.
Yeah, yeah. And do you like songs they put in?
Yeah, I really like the moments everyone like dance and sing. It's really unique and really fun. Right?
So many people like Bollywood movies these days because we are focusing on story based on true and also main topic problems going on in society these days. And yeah, so that's why. And you can also relate to these movies because study sector in Korea is
really
hard.
Yeah. Education system.
Not hard, not like Indo-boda, the Hindroyo.
Oh, also. They're very comparative and.
Yeah. You can feel pressure in Korea.
Yeah. So many pressure. Since they were really young.
Yeah. So that's why these movies are getting popular in your country.
I think that's why.
Yeah, because of you also have that issue, education issue.
Right.
So in that movie, Amir Khan told us like learn subject if you really have interest. People can relate to these movies. That's why they are like getting really popular and you can like inspire by these movies.
Oh, and this question. Is K-pop and K-drama is famous in India?
Yeah, very much. I've been watching K-drama since 2000. Oh no, my first Korean drama was Full House. When I was so little, in Hindi language.
Really?
Yeah. So after that, I was so many dramas regularly. And so many people watch Korean drama. And these days, K-pop is like getting so popular in India too. And we have Indian Army. I am one
Army?
Of them.
Oh, really?
I'm Army.
Oh, I'm Army too. Oh. Army. Who's your bias?
Suga.
I'm Jim. Oh. Okay. Oh, it's an important question. How does living in Korea compare with India?
Oh, so when I came here, it was like going good. But now after living, after like 2-3 months, you will feel the pressure. In India, everything is cheap.
Right.
Like fruits, vegetables, and other things. And here, everything is expensive. So you have to work for that to find job, part-time or something. I have a YouTube channel, so it helped me. I also did my part-time job. It was so tough, but
Doni
mani badasoya.
Fine.
Second thing, I don't know why in India I used to get compliments like you are so beautiful, but here so many give me like compliment like oh you are so beautiful and compliments like this.
That's
I don't
good.
Know. Appearance is so much here. They have mirrors in every subway.
They care about appearance a lot.
Yeah, they take care of that a lot. Yeah, it's good, but sometimes it feels like we have other things too. You have to see talent, you have to see something else.
They just only care about the looks.
Yeah.
They don't see other things like their talent or personality.
Yeah.
That's a good thing and bad thing.
Yeah, pros and cons,
Got it. This is a question I really wanted to ask. Have you ever experienced discrimination as an Indian in Korea?
No. One thing happened when I applied in Korean university, not Seoul Daehagyo, but before Seoul Daehagyo, I applied in different university. They like
rejected you?
Yeah, they rejected me because they said like we are not taking application from India. So I was like, what? Why? And they didn't give any other reason like marks were not good or what was the reason. They just straight up said like we don't accept application from India. Anyone can do language course, but still they rejected me. And yeah, that was the first time or last time that something happened to me. But after coming to Korea, no one, so far no one treated me badly or said anything bad to me, behaved bad towards me or anything like that.
But they're kind to you?
Yeah, so kind, so helpful. I didn't like imagine something like that. Korean people are so good and so kind. And they will help you even they can't.
They like to help.
Yeah. And even they can't talk to in English, still they want to help you. And before coming to Korea, I watched videos like, oh, what should I keep in mind before going to Korea? So I watched some videos and people from America and other countries, they talked about like elder people, like Ajushi, Ajuma, Harmony, Harboji. So they said like they are really rude and they will push you and say you like harsh thing and yeah. But coming to Korea, they are like super helpful. More than
young
people, always on phone, on busy and every time busy and yeah, they don't look up and yeah. Elder people are like always see you if you, if they see like, that foreigner is in some problem, we should help. So yeah, they always take time to help you. Yeah, that's really good thing. So don't think that they are rude. They are really, really kind and helpful. So always think like that and say 안녕하세요 and always bo. Not like 안녕하세요, just 안녕하세요.
예전에 I saw one video that India is dangerous country. The YouTuber, Korean YouTuber said, if you're a woman and if you go India alone, that's really dangerous. Even he have not been there, how did he know that? I was feel really weird, so that's why I make this video. How do you think about that?
Well, whoever made that video, I don't think he ever visited India. So some people made this kind of video to only to get views and get attention and everything, but every day you don't have any idea how many foreigners come to India.
Yeah,
you don't have any idea. Yeah, every country has like problems. Your country has problems, America has problem, every country. So we have problem and I feel bad when I hear about any crime, but we are dealing with everything and we are taking strict laws and we are implementing everything. And yeah, we are handling everything very well. I agree that crimes happen in our country, but our government is taking like good action against that. So yeah, I agree, but it's not, my country is not dangerous at all. You can visit my country anytime.
I want to go too.
Yeah, why not? I will suggest some places. And if you go to like every part is different and you will love my country. Don't think like, don't watch all those videos like whoever saying like India is bad to visit and not for women and people making those videos only to get attraction and views. If you go, you will find like different things and people are so loving in India. And also I watched some videos before coming to Korea and so many people gave me like really unnecessary information about Korea, like I said, like that Ajushi Ajuma's thing, but this is totally different here.
Different with reality.
So yeah, don't think like, oh, if he's saying this and I should change my mind, I will never visit India, blah blah blah. Whatever you are saying on YouTube, it doesn't mean that it's true. You should definitely visit India. It's beautiful country.
Okay.
Especially Taj Mahal. Yeah.
I will go to invite me. Okay. Yeah, I hope it can be helpful to know about India, Johor. The one thing I want to say is, if you have any prejudice or stereotype about certain country, that means you lose your opportunity to know about the country. So
yeah.
I hope that
don't believe
the
whatever you are watching on YouTube.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. So use your mind too.
Don't afraid to go India.
Yeah, or any other country. I will see you in India.
Yeah.
And you too.
Yeah, me too. I will go. Invite me.
Yeah.
Okay, then see you next time.
Bye. Have a nice day. Take care of yourself.
How to say goodbye in
India?
Yeah.
Just kanam namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Bye.
Bye.
안녕히 계세요. 가세요. 아니 아니에요.
모르겠어.
야, 한국 사람이야.
안녕히 계세요.